In today's video, we're going to be looking at logic gates, which is safe to say is one of the nastiest physics topics which you'll have to face. But hopefully together, once we've gone through this video, you'll be able to do every single question perfectly. But we do need to work out what we're talking about. So crucially, a logic gate is a basic building block of a digital circuit. And what do we really mean by that? Well, these are things which are found in electronic devices such as phones, computers, washing machines, and lifts. So they're all around us in everyday life. And the technology which underpins these is logic gates. Now, the thing to notice with logic gates is that they have both inputs and outputs. So you put stuff into them and you get stuff out of them. And weirdly, we call these Boolean values. Don't worry too much about this Boolean value thing. The crucial thing is that the inputs and outputs can only have one of two values, which we assign either true or false, or 1 or 0, and true and 1 are equivalents and false and 0 are equivalents. So looking at this in context, within an electrical circuit, true or 1 means that a current would flow, false or 0 would mean that it wouldn't flow and therefore the device wouldn't work. Now you need to know how a few different types of logic gates work, and I'm going to show you them now. The first and most simple logic gate is the AND gate. You need to be able to draw and recognize it. So I'd start by doing the center part. The output here is X, and our inputs are A and B. So as the name suggests, if we want our output X to effectively work, to be on, i.e. to be true or one, that means all the same thing. Because it's an AND gate, it means that both A and B must be 1. And I'm going to use 1 from now on because it's easier than talking about true or false, but they're totally interchangeable. If A is 1 and B is 0, because both of them aren't 1, you're going to get an output which is off and therefore 0. And similarly, if A is 0, B is 1, again the output will be 0. In order to get an output of 1, according to AND gates, you need both A and B to equal 1. Let's draw this more nicely in a truth table. So we're going to have both our inputs and our outputs. And according to this logic gate, we know that our inputs are both A and B, and our output is X. So let's separate out our table. We need to show all the various combinations of inputs and work out their outputs. So for me, the most straightforward thing here is to have both of the inputs as being false or 0. Because they're both 0, and we know an AND gate only works by having both as being 1, our output will be 0. Now we're going to have an input where A is 1, B is 0. We haven't met the criteria for the AND gate because they're not both 1, so our output is 0. Looking at A being 0 and B equaling 1 this time, we have a similar situation to the last one. Our output will be 0. The last combination is obviously both being 1. Because they're both 1, they're meeting the criteria for the AND gate, so our output will be 1. The next gate we need to look at is the OR gate. So again, be able to recognize, be able to draw it. We've got our output X and our inputs are A and B again. This time the gate is telling you that if crucial
crucial thing to notice here is if either A or B is true, which we know to be 1, the output X will also be true, or 1. So let's look at the table again. So we've got our inputs with A and B in. Our outputs is going to be X, and we need to do the various combinations. So again, starting with 0 going in for both, so false for both. Well, neither is on, so we know our output will be 0. We're going to go in with A being 1, B being 0. We've met the criteria, which is that if either A or B is true or 1, the output will also be true. We've got A being 1, so that's why the output is 1. This time A is 0, B is 1. Similarly, we've got one of them being true or 1, so our output is 1. Lastly, we're having A and B both equaling 1. Well, we've met the fact that if either A or B is true, they're both true, we're going to have a similar output, which is true. Looking now at the NOT gate, here's the symbol you need to know for this. There's your output. Your input is just a single value, which is A. This time, we only have one input and one output. And the NOT gate is simply telling us to do the opposite of what's going in. So for example, if our input A is 1, then we're going to be doing the opposite with our output, so the output will be 0. If A is 0, we do the opposite for the output, and that will therefore be 1. So we have a very simple truth table here. We're labelling our input as A, our output as X. So if our input is 1, the opposite of this will be 0. If our input is 0, the opposite will be 1. It gets more complicated now when we look at the NAND gate. Now notice again how it's drawn, and this blob here makes it a NAND gate rather than an AND gate. Now the crucial thing to notice is that these combine the NOT gate with the AND gate. So what the NAND gate is telling us to do is to do the opposite of the AND gate. So what does that mean? Well, if A and B are both 1, if it was an AND gate, we know the output would be 1, but it's a NAND gate, so we look at the opposite, so the output will be 0. If A is 1 and B is 0, we know with an AND gate that would automatically mean that the output would be 0. However, we have a NAND gate, which is the opposite, which is why we have a 1. And then similarly, if we swap those over so that A is 0, B is 1, again, we have an output which is 1. Now let's look at it inside a truth table, which is the same as what I've just written, but probably easier to see. So starting with both having an input of 0, in the case of an AND gate, that would mean that the output would be 0. However, we've got the opposite here, which means the output is 1. With A being 1, B equals 0, with an AND gate, the output would be 0. However, the NAND gate means it's the opposite, so it's 1. Swapping them over, again, it wouldn't meet the criteria for an AND gate, so the output would be 0. We do the opposite for the NAND gate, the output is 1. And lastly, if they're both 1, then in the case of an AND gate, the output would be 1, so we do the opposite for the NAND, so it's 0. As the name suggests, it is the opposite of an OR gate. So to put this into context, if either A or B is 1, in the case of an OR gate, that would mean that the output would be 1, but we're doing the opposite of an OR gate, which means the output would be 0. If A is 1 and B is 1, in the case of an OR gate, that would mean the output would be 1, but we're doing the opposite, so the output is 0. And then lastly, if A was 0 and B was 0, then in the case of an OR gate, it would obviously have an output of 0, but we're doing the opposite for an OR gate, so that would be 1. Truth table time. So starting with A and B equaling 0, if it was an OR gate, the output would be 0. We're doing the opposite with the NOR gate, so the output is 1. With A being 1, B equaling 0, with an OR gate, the output would be 1, but we're doing the opposite, so it is 0. Swapping them over, and you would have 0 again. And then lastly, if you have both inputs being 1, with an OR gate, the output would be 1. We've got a NOR gate, so we do the opposite, so it is 0. So these are our 5 logic gates, and now we need to look at where multiple gates are put in a single question, and we need to understand how we're going to work out our answer. So we're going to complete a truth table for the following logic system. So we're going to be completing a truth table now for this question. So first of all, we need to identify the type of logic gates we have, and because we have a triangle with a blob, it tells us that it is a NOT gate. This gate over here is an AND gate. So we're going to be looking at an input over here, which is A, and our first output here, which is C. So let's start by doing our logic tables for that. So let's do the various combinations where we need A to be 0, 0, 1, or 1. The reason why I've written 0 and 1 twice is because we need to consider the AND gate. So let's start by working it out. So putting in 0 into a NOT gate will mean you get the opposite as the output, which means you get 1, 1, and then the opposite of 1 is obviously 0. So now we're looking at the AND gate, and what are the inputs going into the AND gate? They're going to be C and B. Now remember, we need every single combination covering. So if C is going in as 1, then we need to have B going in as 1. If C is going in as 1, then we have to have a different combination, so we're going to say 0 here. If 0 is going into C, then we could have B being 0. And the last combination is 0 going into C and 1 going into B. And now we have both of the inputs for the AND gate, which is both C and B. We can now start working out the output, which is Q. Just looking at the C and B column, we know it's an AND gate, which means both C and B need to be true. They both need to be 1 to get an output of 1. So for the first row, they both are 1, which means our output is 1. And then for all the rows beneath, we don't have 2 1s. We only have either 1 1 or no 1s. So we're going to have 0 as our output. And that's your final answer. Let's look at a past exam question just to make you feel doubly confident. So we've got figure 10.2 showing a digital circuit, and we want to complete the truth table for this circuit. So first of all, identify your gates. So we've got an AND gate here. This here is an OR gate. Okay, so let's look at what's going into our AND gate first of all. So we've got our inputs A and B, and remember, both of these need to equal 1 for a 1 to be the output at C. We've got 0 going in at both A and B, which means we know the output C will be 0. And to be honest, you could just look down and have a look at and see where you've got both inputs being 1, and you know those will be 1 and everything else will be 0. I mean, you can sit there and painstakingly work it out, but you don't really need to. Looking now at the OR gate, so we've got the inputs being C and D, so we're just looking at these columns to work out our output of E. And remember, with an OR gate, the inputs need to have a minimum of 1 true value. So you need a minimum of 1, 1, if that makes sense. So looking at output C and input D as both being 0. Clearly neither of these are 1, so the output will be 0. You have a 1 as the input D, so that qualifies for the OR gate, which is why you have an output of 1. Neither of the next row are 1, so that's an output of 0, and you can just go down and look for a minimum of 1 input. And that's the final answer here. Right, I hope you found this helpful, guys. Logic gates are tricky, and it is really important that you do learn to recognize them, because if you don't recognize them, how can you possibly work out the correct outputs? But hopefully you've seen that this is actually very manageable.